मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर टू रिगार्डिंग द चैप्टर नंबर वन ऑफ सिविक्स ऑन इक्वालिटी, राइट? यस स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द पॉलिटिकल इक्वालिटी. इन द कांता स्टोरी वी एक्सपीरियंस दैट मैनी पीपल ऑफ द कंट्री हैव पॉलिटिकल इक्वालिटी लाइक राइट टू वोट. But still they are facing some social inequality. The most of the reasons of the persons who believe in inequality in our India are that some people are wealthy while some are poor. Some have to stand in the queue for their turn in the hospital for the treatment, while some have direct contact with the doctor. They do not need to stand in the queue, right? And the third is, some people have to borrow the money for their livelihood, and while some have richer section, belong to the richer section of the society, correct? Now, apart from these inequality, there are some other kinds of equality we will discuss in this part. Here you can see on your screen some other kinds of equality, like apart from being poor, poor people in India experience inequality in different ways. Some other ways we will discuss through which we will able to understand that some types of inequalities are still prevailing in India, right? So one of the more common forms of inequality in India is the caste system. One of these inequality, the most common form, is a caste system. You all are familiar with the caste system. In our Indian society, there are four castes: Brahman, Vaishya, Shudra, and Kshatriya. है ना? Kshatriya, Brahman, Vaishya, and Shudra. Shudra are the lowest rank in the caste system in India, है ना? Which is also known as untouchability. We will discuss this kind of inequality in India in this section. So let us read a story about the experiences of Dalit child attending school. So this story belongs to the untouchability. You all are familiar with the untouchability. What do you mean by untouchability? Some section, or we can say one section of our society, is deprived from the social and economic status like other pupils. Like they are not allowed to sit with the rich people and the other section of the society. They can't enter in the public places. They can't use the public things like well, temples, etc. They have to live separate from the main society. So they are considered as the untouchable. So this story belongs to the untouchability. A story of a child. Basically, these stories are based on real incidents in people's lives and reflects the different kinds of inequalities that exists in India. If you live in rural India, beta, your caste identity is something that you probably learned or experienced very young, right? So we will discuss this through the story. First of all, what is Dalit? Dalit is a term that the so-called lower caste use to address themselves. This is a word given by the untouchables to themselves. They address themselves as Dalit. What the Dalit means? Literal meaning of Dalit is broken. Broken means into pieces. And by using this word, what they mean, that the lower castes are pointing to how they were and continue to be seriously discriminated against. By using this mean, they want to describe their living conditions in our country. They are strongly discriminated by the other sections of the society. So they gave themselves the name Dalit, right? And it belongs to the untouchability. Remember that, right? So the story refers to the Om Prakash Valmiki. It is an autobiography of Om Prakash Valmiki when he was a child, and it is representing the caste system in India. So what he wrote in his autobiography, firstly, Om Prakash Valmiki from 1950 to 2013 is a famous Dalit writer, right? Remember that he was a famous Dalit writer. What happened in his childhood now? In his autobiography, Jhoothan, the name of his autobiography is Jhoothan. Here you can see the front page of his autobiography in the picture, Jhoothan, A Dalit's Life. He wrote his autobiography. Autobiography means the real incident of his own life. Correct? So in his autobiography, Jhoothan, he writes, I had to sit away from the others in the class and that too on the floor, right? He is discriminated in the school when all the pupils are sitting together, he had to sit away from the others and even on the floor also. As you come in the school, there is no discrimination right now. When you came into the school, you sit all together, but he had to sit away from reaching the set door. Sometimes I would have to sit way behind everybody, right near. Sometimes they would beat me without any reason. He is describing his circumstances which he was facing during his childhood. He had to sit on the floor without any mat, sometimes near the door. Frequently happened that some other childs treated badly him. Even sometimes they would beat him and without any reason. When he was in class 4th, that was the incident of when he was in the class 4th, the headmaster asked Om Prakash to sweep the school and the playground. Not only the children or the student of the school, even the staff, even the headmaster means principal and the teachers also follow the discrimination, follow this procedure with him. Even his headmaster named Om Prakash asked him to clean the school and the playground. But he was just only in the fourth standard. He was a child. He writes, the playground was way larger than my small physique could handle and in cleaning it. A fourth class standard student can't be able to clean the whole school and even the playground. He is not physically too small fit to clean all the playground and the school. My back began to ache. There was pain in his back. My face was covered with dust. Even he is saying that his face was covered with dust when he was cleaning the school and the playground. Some dust had gone inside my mouth. The other children in my class were studying and I was sweeping. The school where we studied. We go to the school for study, but he has to sweep the school instead of studying in it while other children were studying. Headmaster was sitting in his room and watching me. I was not even allowed to get a drink of water because untouchability was prevailing there. He can't use the public essentials. I swept the whole day from the doors and windows of the school rooms. The eyes of the teachers and the boys saw this spectacle. Everyone was seeing these. What conditions was going on? He was sweating very much. He was very thirsty, but nobody allowed to drink water to him. Om Prakash was made to sweep the school and the playground for the next couple of days, and this only came to an end when his father, who happened to be passing by, saw his son sweeping. This procedure is going on for the next 2 days, but how it comes to an end? When his father was passing there and he saw his son, that he is cleaning the school and the playground, he confronted the teachers and then walking away from the school holding Om Prakash's hand, he said loudly for all of them to hear, "You are a teacher, so I am leaving now. But remember this, much master, he will study right here in this school." So he pointing out the teachers that who were seeing these procedure to be going on, and he warned them that one day will come when my child will study in this same school, and not just him, but there will be more coming after him. Not my only my child, many more will come after him. So he warned the teachers and hold the hand of his son and took him away from the school. So in this case, you have seen that what kind of untouchability is prevailing in India. Some child are enjoying to study in the school, while some are discriminating from the elementary education also, right? So this story shows the caste system in India. The second story is based on an incident that took place in one of India's larger cities and is common practice in most parts of the country. The first story belongs to the rural areas students, and the second story belongs to the urban areas. Not only in the rural areas, even in the urban areas, some discrimination, some inequalities are also prevailing in the larger cities of India also. Other kinds of incidents or stories throws a light on these inequalities. The second story is about Mr. and Mrs. Ansari, representing religious discrimination in India. So with this story, you will be able to understand the religious discrimination in India. Main religions of India are, you all are familiar with the religion. There are many more religion in India, that like Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Christians, Parsis, hai na? So there is a religious discrimination in India also. So it is a story about Mr. and Mrs. Ansari, who were looking to rent an apartment in the city. They want a room or a building on rent in the city. Mr. and Mrs. Ansari, as their name suggests, they were Arab. They belong to the Arab religious community, means Muslims. They had the money, and so paying the rent was no problem. So they could pay the rent very easily. They went to a property dealer for help to find a place. The dealer informed that he knew about quite a few apartments that were available for rent. So the dealer told them that there are few apartments, they could hire them. They visited the first apartment, and what was going on? The Ansaris liked it very much and decided to take it. They liked the apartment and wanted it on the rent. But what happened? However, when the landlady found out their names, she made an excuse about how she could not rent the house to someone who ate meat because the building did not have any non-vegetarian residents. means when he heard their names, Mr. and Mrs. Ansari, she came to know that they are Muslims, and she made an excuse that I couldn't give you the house on the rent because the area or the community belongs to us, we would not allow to the people who ate meat. But truth was some other. Both the Ansaris and the property dealer were surprised to hear this, because they could smell fish being cooked in the neighbor's house, because the landlady was making the fake statement by saying this, that who ate meat, I couldn't give the house on the rent. But fact was that they could smell the cooked fish in the neighbor's house. So they were able to understand that she was not willing to give them house on the rent. The same excuse was repeated in the second, in the third apartments. And finally, the property dealer told them that they might want to change their names and call themselves Mr. and Mrs. Kumar. So they could represent themselves as Hindus, and they will easily able to hire the house on the rent. But the Ansaris were reluctant to do this. They refused to this proposal and decided to look some more. In the end, it took a whole month of looking at apartments before they found a landlady who was willing to give them a place on rent. Finally, after 1 month, one landlady was agreed to give them a place on rent. So in this story, you were able to understand how the religious discrimination is prevailing in India. Hindus and the other religious communities are not willing to be with the Muslims community. Right? So in this picture, but you can see the dignity, recognizing dignity. Here in this picture, you can see one man is asked a child to polish his shoes. Basically, it is a picture of film Diwar in 1975, and this picture is also showing the child labor as well as inequality and hurting the dignity of the people also. When he threw a coin to that child who polished his shoes, his dignity harmed. And in the young stage, he was Amitabh Bachchan, you know. So this kind of inequalities are also showing in our film city also, right? Because these films are the true scenario of our social and political life to a limited extent. Now, recognizing dignity. What is dignity? Dignity means respect to all. All the persons in India, all the persons in India have some dignity. They want to be respected. When persons are treated unequally, their dignity is violated. The caste we are born into, the religion we practice, the class background we come from, whether we are male or female, these are often the things that determine why some people are treated unequally. So, because these are the basic roots of the discrimination, like religious background, the class means the caste background, male or female, all these are the basic roots of the inequality in India. Next, respect and dignity to all. As you saw in the story of Prakash and the Ansari, do not deserve to be treated like this, because just because they belong to like Om Prakash, he belonged to the untouchable or the lower caste, and the Ansari, he belonged to the Muslim community. Even beyond these religious or caste communities, they are, first of all, they all are human beings. So they deserve the same respect and dignity as anyone else. When persons are Om Prakash Valmiki's schoolmates and teachers hurt his dignity badly and made him feel as if he was less than equal to all other students in the school. So Om Prakash Valmiki could do very little about the situation because he was too young. But it was his father who, on seeing his son's fame, felt angry by this unequal treatment and confronted the teachers. In the Ansari's case, the Ansari's dignity was also hurt when persons refused to lease their apartments to them. However, when the property dealer suggested that they change their name, it was their dignity or self-respect that made them refuse these suggestions. So Om Prakash and the Ansaris do not deserve to be treated like this. They deserve the same respect and dignity as anyone else. So here we discuss the two types of inequalities, inequalities prevailing in India. First is caste system and second is religious discrimination. These are the two another ways of inequalities in India. Now, what is the solution to remove this inequality from India? First is the parliament. That is the cornerstone of our democracy. Parliament, in the parliament, our representative made the government, and these representatives are from each section of the society. Now, what our Indian constitution makes to prevail the equality in Indian democracy? The Indian constitution recognizes every person as equal. According to our constitution, every and each person of India is treated to be as equal. This means that every individual, every person in the country, including whether he is a male or female, whether he belongs to the higher caste or the lower caste, whether he belongs to any religion, Hindu, Muslims, Sikhs, Christians, Parsis, tribes, scheduled tribes or scheduled castes, any educational background, whether he is literate or illiterate, economic backgrounds, means whether he is rich or poor, all are recognized as equal. They are equal before the constitution with irrespect of any caste, religion, tribes, educational and economic backgrounds. This is not to say that inequality ceases to exist. It doesn't mean that inequality is not still prevailing in India. It doesn't. But at least in democratic India, the principle of the equality of all persons is recognized. Even the equality, the term equality is recognized for all the persons in written form in our constitution. But before this constitution, when we were dependent on British culture, while earlier no law existed to protect people from discrimination and ill treatment, now there are several that work to see that people are treated with dignity as equals. Because our constitution recognized every person as equal, nobody could be ill treated or discriminated, you know, on the basis of caste, religion and tribes. And if it happens, we can go to the court. But before that, there was not such a law to protect the people who are facing this type of inequalities. This recognition of equality includes some of the following provisions in the constitution. What are the provisions given by our constitution to prevail the equality in India? First, that every person is equal before the law. What this means is that every person, from the president to the country of a kanta, a domestic worker, has to obey the same laws. Means the law is equal for all, whether he is a government official or a minister or a cobbler or a worker. Everyone is equal before the law. Second, no person can be discriminated against on the basis of their religion, race, caste, place of birth, or whether they are female or male. I already told you about that. The third, every person has access to all public places, including playgrounds, hotels, shops, and markets. All persons can use publicly available wells, roads, and bathing huts. Now, these days, if you went to a hotel, you never asked the waiters or the managers who is sitting just next to your table, you know, because all are equal. Irrespective of any religion, any caste, people can go to the any public places. We can't refuse them to enter in the public places as well as for the public facilities available for all. Fourth, untouchability has been abolished. Untouchability has been abolished, and now untouchability is a legal offense. If anyone treated someone badly or ill-treated someone on the basis of untouchability, he or she can be punished. Now, what are the ways to implement the equality? The two ways in which the government has tried to implement the equality that is guaranteed in the constitution is, a constitution had written that everyone is equal before the law, no one can be discriminated. But in the original scenario, how it can be implemented? Why we cannot resist it only in the written form? So first way is through laws. Constitution or the government made some laws to prevent equality in India. Second, through government programs or schemes to help disadvantaged communities. Disadvantaged communities means from other sections. So made some programs and schemes to help them, right? So there are several laws in India that protect everyone, every person's right to be treated equally. Like untouchability is abolished, as I told you earlier. So one of the way is sustainable development goal is SDG is zero hunger. Means the main aim of the government to prevail the equality, social and economic equality, is zero hunger. Everyone in the country have the right to access good hygienic and healthy food. This is the main aim of our government, and the government provided some schemes and programs to achieve this goal. We will discuss these achievements or these schemes in our next lecture. Now, if you have any doubt regarding this lecture or this topic, you can ask now.